y'all go back to your brown country bitches.
They racist. They racist.
It's exactly what it is. It's racist. You're being
black man.
I don't give a what's your.
Ladies and gentlemen, I wish you Karen would.
You want to call the police on them for having a barbecue on a Sunday?
You're still free. Back off.
I'm going to tell them there's an African American man threatening my life.
This story is a little more complex, but this particular Karen defends her racist comments by saying, I'm married to a black man. Damn. That's a hell of a marriage, obviously. So this particular Karen was caught telling a Hispanic couple to go back to your brown country. Obviously a racist statement meant to be offensive to this couple. This was following a parking lot altercation. She'd even attempted to defend herself by saying she was married to a black man before this escalation to a racist conversation began. This Karen actually slapped the woman. Now listen, I have to show you how we can tell she slapped the female in this story, and I want you to catch it. You got to watch it closely. Here it is.
In the car. Call the cops. In the car. If you don't want to tell me, I'll call the cops.
Tell you what.
Okay, give me. Look, your husband kicked my in. I didn't damage Joe's car. He kicked that in. I have video of it. You shut the up, bitch.
You dumbass bitch.
No, you're
don't talk to me, not him. Okay, I'm right here.
Has to call his wife? Can't deal with it? Look. What is this?
First of all, don't.
We have cameras, that's what I'm saying. I didn't hear your. And then you're like, I'm gonna text my wife. My wife will handle this.
I'm not about to call you, which I'm calling her to talk to you.
But did she? No, she came swinging at me.
You hear her face.
No.
It's exactly what it is. It's racist. You're being I don't give a what you're married to. Look what you just said. Go back to your country.
Yeah.
Really?
Y'all brown.
I'm American.
And if your husband's black, then what the
normal? No, you're not.
I didn't leave the scene. I'm still here. I didn't have no papers and nothing. I left.
You do not get to inoculate yourself against being a racist just because of who you sleep with. Please understand that. It's very clear that in this story, in this confrontation, she decided to be bigoted and racist against this particular couple. Now, it was a dispute, a parking lot dispute. She decided to make it racial. That's what she decided to do. And I hope you saw the shadow that clearly showed this white female slapping the victim. Let's play that again. You saw that? Here it comes. Look at the shadow clearly. And then she even said, oh, no, your wife swung at me. No, you hit his wife. She defended herself. Okay? Ben, what are your thoughts?
My thought is that they really should stop. They really should consider that they're going to get a feature on I Wish a Karen Would and keep acting like this. because at this point, we're leaving no stone unturned. We're identifying Karens at every turn. If you want to be famous, then just keep acting the way white supremacy has let you get away with acting. And this is what it is. Like, there's a lot of people who are uncomfortable with the fact that they can no longer get away with what they used to get away with. We used to say the N-word and nobody say anything. We used to slap you in public and nobody say anything. We used to get angry because you could be in our quote unquote space that we colonized and no one would say anything. But now we got all of these videos and everyone wants something to say. And this is tied directly to critical race theory, as you were saying earlier. Not only do they don't want the present to be told accurately, they don't want the past to be told accurately.
Very well said. Very well said. And remember, the reason why they're willing to act in this manner, to be physically aggressive, to assault individuals, to be racist and bigoted in their conversation and argumentation. The reason why is because typically they have been protected in those very same spaces. There has been a level of protection. I guarantee you, when the police arrived, she tells them, oh, no, this person hit me. No, it was the fault of that individual. I had nothing to do with them. But that's why it's important we highlight the reality of truth on this program. Because the more we expose this kind of behavior, the more we're able to have a better sense of how these things happen before the police arrive. And so I'm very proud of the work we continue to do here with all of our segments.